I can hold the mic. Are you guys good?
Good.
Yep.
Yeah, so, I mean, I guess just first of all, I'll start with you, Peter. Just your reaction to learning the news about this just over here.
Well, I'm saddened that Lyle's a close friend of mine and someone that I have just tremendous respect for, as he's been not only one of my closest colleagues, friends in caucus and cabinet. He's been a mentor over the last 7 years that I have had the opportunity to serve in the government of Saskatchewan. So first and foremost, my thoughts are with Lyle as a friend as he embarks on this battle. But I know you'll be successful, and second, we'll work our way through the cabinet piece as we go through the next week or so. But my thoughts are with my friend as he embarks on this second journey now with a disease that. He'll lick here before tomorrow.
And so, I mean, it's just it's been a long time. Cadmus, you're not only obviously under former Premier Wall as well. He was, I mean, losing someone from that position. He's been there for, it's been a kind of steady hand in that same role for almost a decade.
We've had two ministers of agriculture since we formed government in 2007, and I'd say two great ministers of agriculture, and I'll leave them to sort out which one was the greatest. But we have Bob Benrod and Lyle Stewart, and so this is not lost on me, the importance of this role in our province's economy. It's not lost on me the opportunity that we have had as a province and as a governing party since 2007 to have these two fine gentlemen serve in that role. So, a very impactful decision faces myself, one that I would rather not make. I'd rather have Lyle continue to serve in this role, barring this diagnosis. So that would be my first comment. The second comment is the impact that Lyle has had as a cabinet minister and as a member of government, and he'll continue to be a member of government, I might add, throughout this, and he'll continue to be a confidant and a guiding voice for the premier of this province as well as we move forward. But he has been a very impactful voice in the cabinet room, in the caucus room, and within members of government in his time being elected since 1999, but also in his time serving the people of the province since 2007 as part of the government of the province. And that will not be missed. As I said, he will continue to serve as an MLA, and he'll continue to be a strong voice within the government of the province on behalf of the people that he represents in Lumsden Morse, but also on behalf of the industry of agriculture and the great experience that he has had as a private citizen, but also as a public servant.
So I don't know if you want to see him to shuffle over. You guys want to turn it in?
I'll just like flip it over.
Sure. Yeah.
You guys good?
Yep.
So, I mean, I guess just first of all, why this decision? Why now? I know this is not your first time. They've gone through something like this, but why this time are you deciding to step down?
Well, this looks like it's going to be a little more protracted fight than the last one, and. According to the treatment plan they've laid out for me, it's going to be about a year. And I don't expect to be at my best for a good part of that year. And I have no doubt between my own personal stubbornness and a great team of healthcare professionals that we'll win this battle. But Saskatchewan agriculture deserves it. A full-time minister that's really up to the job, and the premier has some good choices he can make from within our caucus to do that job, and I'm proud of the job that we've done over the last 6 years and 3 months, and in fact the last 11 years that we've been government, I'm proud of the job that I've done in the last 6 years, and as minister, it hasn't all been perfect, but as far as human beings go, I worked hard at it, and I think we've accomplished some good things, and I want to leave on that note. I don't want to hang around and do half a job.
How's your family dealing with this situation?
Beg your pardon?
How's your family dealing with the news?
Oh, my kids all came home for a nice visit this summer, and that was really good. The family's very supportive, and I think pretty confident.
And so just some timeline stuff. So you say, was it earlier this summer that you found out about this, and then you made this decision just this past weekend, or when was this decision made?
Over the last week or so, in conversations with the Premier, we've come to this point. You know, the Premier was fantastic. He gave me all the flexibility in